You have seen, I have given some reference of UDHR Article 19 and at the same time International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights Article 19 also. There are in both the international law, there are Article 19s. Article 19 UDHR, there is no exception. Whereas under Article 19 of International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, there are some exceptions. But these exceptions can be exercised as a power by the member states by making the law. And a 1 and 2 clause of 19, you have seen that there is no interference and without the imposition of any restriction, any person have the right as a political right to express speech and other thoughts through the media, and our subject is the media. But clause 3 have some provisions relating to the exception which can be imposed by the member states on speech and expression, thoughts and other kinds of opinion, information, to seek the information and impart the information. These are the words there under Article 19. International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights. Why these are called the civil and political rights? I have given the reference which we had discussed some rights under that course prescribed by the university for the LLM first semester students that we have already seen. Why it is called the civil and political rights? It is called because these rights are for the civilian. Civilian means citizens. If you will see some ideology of jurisprudential system, this is called jus civile. Jus includes the law. Civile means for the citizen. And for others also, there is, you are hearing to me, all the students, I am audible.
Because yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir. You audible?
Okay. Thank you. Because some are calling me. And okay. Now this is the provisions under the civil and political rights. And why it is called the civil? I have referred the Roman law. Under the Roman law, you might be heard as a natural law. That the jus civile, jus gentium, and the with jus naturel, there are three categories. And the civil origin of this word civil is from that point of view, from the Latin word, which is called jus civile. Jus civile means, if you will see the book written by John Salmon on the jurisprudence, you will get that this word jus civile. J-U-S, jus is, the meaning of jus is the law. Its meaning is the law. And another side, the civile means citizen. Citizen. So therefore, whenever you will see the covenant, international covenant on civil and political rights, it means these rights are for the citizens, citizens of the country. And these rights are given by the recognized by the state. And that's why these are the political rights. This cannot be taken away and it cannot be violated. It cannot be abridged and it cannot be in any way interference by the persons or by the regime who are in power. But by making some law, the restriction can be imposed. As you have seen, some provisions are under Article 19 also. You have also seen that when we were discussing the 66 and 69, 60, that was related to the IT Act. IT Act is 69 and 69A under the IT Act, and there are some words and some difference we have already seen in between the Article 19 Clause 2 and the 69 and 69A. Again, today I will refer some matters here for the purpose of civil and political rights as embodied or it is prescribed under the international instruments that is called the covenant on the civil and political rights. It is for the all international communities who are the member of the United States. But the point number 3, 1 and 2 yesterday I have discussed. The point number 3 says that the restriction can be imposed for the purpose. There are the some grounds on which grounds the restriction can be imposed. This is the issue, but the grounds already written under clause 3 of Article 19 of the Covenant on Civil and Political Rights. And it says that these restrictions can be special duties and responsibility. It may therefore the subject to certain restriction. If you will see the line number 2, last line after the 1.5 under clause, the 3, that says that it may therefore be subject to certain restriction. It means a restriction can be imposed, but these shall only be such as provided by law and are necessary. As provided by law and are necessary. It means the law, it requires to be made. Unless the law shall not be made, the restrictions by order, executive by order of the executive order, it cannot be imposed. Law. And whenever the law relating to this restriction, imposing of restriction on this speech, expression, opinion, information seek and impart through the media. Through the media. That is our point. Because we are as a subject are searching the provisions where there are the legal provisions for the media. Thus, there is a question of through the media. It means a restriction can be imposed, but for that purpose, the law shall be made by the state. And that law is not included any executive order. It is a legislation. Its intention is legislation. And for respect to the others, what will be the ground for making the law? Just like the defamation. Defamation is the word under 19 clause 2. And this is the word, as you have seen, that there was no word under 69 IT Act. But if you will see the Cinematography Act of 1952, I will discuss that one. And there are 17 sections. And 5 is very long section. A, B, C, D capitals are there. And you might be seen in the movie picture that U certificate, A certificate, S certificate. And the certificate, it requires to be taken from the board. There is one act which is called the Cinematography Act of 1952. And if you will see the section 5B, the restrictions can be imposed on the movie. Restriction can be imposed on the picture. And a certificate cannot be issued to the applicant. That may be the director. And if there are the grounds, and the grounds are the same, I will discuss this part also, but with the reference of this clause 3, I'm just correlating the other aspect which are existing in other laws in India also. Thus, the first point is relating to the for respect of the rights of rights or reputation of others. It is a very wide one side. It has given in one place. It has given the word the reputation of others. It means not to defame to others and not to abuse to others and not to indicate to others. That is the reputation, which is called the reputation, have the relationship with the dignified life of the individual. And that dignified life means whenever a person will defame, whenever a person will abuse to another, whenever a person will commit any crime against any other person, that can be restricted. That speech and expression or the opinion, so on, without any interference can be restricted. One have no power to abuse another person. One have no power to defame another person. One have no power to interfere into the dignified life of another person. One have no power to interfere into the freedoms of another person. Because one's liberty is up to that point where the another person's nose cannot start it, or it has not been started. It is a restriction. Boundary is there. The limitation is there. It means the reputation of another person have the same authenticity, legal authenticity, as the right of the person to express and to speak just like through the media. These are the equal. Balance requires to be made. Therefore, whenever it will be violated, the reputation shall be violated, the law can be made. Means law already has been made, but the ground is that a ground shall be written in that law that it shall not be interfered into the reputation of the any other person. And at the same time, it says that for the respect of the rights, reputation, okay, defamation, abuse, and all the things, but respect is, as I have said, one place reputation, and another place, the respect of the rights. It means it is a very wide term. Why it is a wide term? Because respect to the rights means not to interfere any kind of rights. Right to livelihood, right to life, right to liberty, right not to torture, right inform to the allegation within certain time, and the various rights are there, which says that equality rights, other natural rights, right to basically of being a human being, right to determine that he is the human being, he is not an animal existing, this is also right. And another right, you can say the right to get education, right to health, right to food. So many rights are there. Bundle of rights are there. Not to torture to any person. So reputation is one side, but the not to interfere the rights of other person or respect the rights of another person. Whenever one will interfere into the rights of another person, for example, a simple example is there, criminal trespass. Within the property where there is the possession of another person. It is very simple. Without the permission, if A enters into the property of B, who have the legal authority to hold it, it shall be called a interference in the rights of another person, because he has entered into that premises without the permission of another person. So therefore, respect the rights of others. A law law shall be made by the state to impose some restriction on it. Second part said that three. I am talking about the clause 3B. This was the A. The second says that for the protection of national security. This is everywhere. Everywhere. In every provision there is that sovereignty, security, integrity, friendly relationship, and the other aspect, you can say the morality, decency, other words are there, defamation, excitement, not to excitement of any offense, contempt of court. These are the common words. 10 words are there. In some places it is 7, some places it is 8, some places it 9, and in complete words are 10. For that purpose, and the same words, not same words, but some of the words has written under clause B of sub clause B of clause 3, which says that the protection of national security or the public order, I have discussed what is the meaning of public order. You might be aware that whenever you will write, that should be in your mind, the definition of the public order. It is not law and order, it is a public order. To violate the peace and tranquility in the society. This is called the public order. Nuisance, I have given the example. Again, I think that there is no need to repeat it, because once the example has been given, legal example, it should be in your mind whenever we are talking about it, and that should be immediately in your mind that what is the meaning of public order. And the order public within the bracket, public order and order public. Once the order has been passed by the executive according to the provision of law, if that shall be violated, for example, to impose the 144 CRPC, I'm talking the example, I'm just citing the example of Indian legal system. 144, it has been ordered that the by the pronouncement that the publicity it has been notified, it has been publicized that the 144 of the CRPC has imposed in a certain area. And order public, it means order is there. And if any person shall violate this 144, the action can be taken. This is an example, because I am citing the example of Indian law and discussing the international law. And under the section 188, you know better than me, because you are preparing for your competitive examination. And there is a punishment under IPC 188. And immediately, the action shall be taken by the executive magistrate. And that person will be arrested. Then legal proceeding shall be initiated against the person who has violated the order public. That is within bracket public order, order public. Not to disturb and not to violate tranquility, peace, and not to create any kind of disturbance. But at the same time, order once has been passed, then followed that order. And if it shall be violated, then law shall take its own course. That is the point there under clause, sub-clause B of clause 3 of the International Covenant on the Civil and Political Rights, or of the public health or morals. Public health is written in other places also. Now the health is very easy to define, and you will get the definition of health. But the morality, what is the morality? Morality is very complicated word. It is very complicated word. It cannot be applied everywhere in a same manner. Morality means what is the thinking of the society, what is the civilized category, means criteria of that society, what is the literacy rate of that society, how much they are the educated or knowledgeable person living in the society, what is their status also. A moral which can be illegal in a particular society may not be illegal in another society because of that. But general morality, legal general morality, which says that not to interfere, and which means one line definition you can make, which is prescribed under the provision of law as a immoral. For example, immoral trafficking is there. World, you might be heard under Article 23 of the Constitution, and the Separation 1956 laws are there, and another law in a workplace, there is the if immoral such type of work is there. Trafficking, you might be heard in under the Indian Penal Code also. That is not permissible. This is if there is a legal provision that to violate the dignity and the reputation and respect of another person by the offender, that comes under that word which is prescribed under this restriction as a special ground under subclause B of the 3 on the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights. Therefore, the morality is already defined, but sometimes the definition of morality may be some flexibility. Although there are the law, codified laws, and if that morality incorporated in that provisions, then moral turpitude, a person can be suspended, terminated from the service, public service, that is called in simple world the government service, because there is a difference. Whenever you are using the word the public service and the government service, there is a difference, because a public service is all the incorporations and all the sectors who are getting the salary from the government public fund, they are under the public services. But at the same time, government servant is somehow different. And there are some pure government departments, and they may be called the government servant. But if you will see, the university services, professors, lecturers, readers, and others are working as the under the public services. A corporation servant means a worker who is working in the corporation. If it is a public corporation, he is called the public servant, not the government servant. So my indication is that whenever we are using the words, whenever one is using the words, including the student and the teacher, the immediately the answer of that words should be should come in mind. If that is not coming, then immediately open the dictionary and search the meaning of that word, so that in future, whenever it will require to be used that words, the person who is using or who is required to be used that words will immediately understand the meaning, so that if that words shall not be appropriate to write in under that sentence, he and she will change that words. Thus, the public services, and it has written that the morals, what I am talking about, the public health, health as a whole. For example, you are very much aware about this ordinance, epidemic laws also, which was at that time when it had been said that Vishal Joshi disconnected. What can I do? Now the point is that if any person is just like to violating the provision that to use the mask and to make the social distance, physical distance, not to create the panic, there is a law, and this is the question of public health. And if law is there, then immediately he will be arrested. If order has been passed that the today lockdown, that no person will open own shop, will not go in a public place where he is working, because there is a law, order has been passed, and you might be seen that 2 and 3 deaths are also there when they have not closed the doors and not shut down the doors of the shop, and the police has arrested immediately. This is a question of public health. And to protect the public health, this is the supreme duty, legal duty, and a restriction can be imposed for the purpose of business. Business, because you have seen the media, and the means of media is one of the use of the Article 19(1)(g) also, that you have seen in Indian Supreme Court, Anuradha Bhasin's case, paragraph 28. So immediately it may come your mind. These are the cases of 2020. I am discussing with you, and immediately it should be come in your mind also. Your blood is fresh, your memory is fresh, you are young enough, and I have also read, you have also read. Therefore, even if the teacher is not discussing that one, but indication should be made in your answer book. That is for this purpose, that is essential, which I have correlated here and there in the various places, and you can also correlate it. In many competitive examinations, the question may not be asked, or it is not normally asked by the examiner from the adjective from the chapter. Means the chapter, the same chapter, they cannot ask it, but the shape of the question will be somehow different. Then correlative and application of mind it requires. Then after that, one is the another, because that in Zoom the limited time is here, and unless I will not take your class, I am not feeling well. That is my habit, to take the class of the student. It is very essential for me. And that is basically of the nature also. Then the question is relating to the other provisions, international provisions. We say that what are these? I am just citing another provision. That is the provision of the Convention for the Protection of Human Rights and Fundamental Freedom. Because I have started yesterday that this the freedom of press and media. That is one of the human right. I have said, then these are the provisions under the human right international instruments. That is the point. And thus, I am just quoting this these provisions. And one another is, European Convention is also there. Other conventions are there. Regional conventions are there. International public international conventions are there. Means laws are there. That just I have cited UDHR and that covenant on civil and political rights. This is called public international provision. Because it is being applied, or it have the force of its application on the all the member states. But some are called the regional. And what are these regional? For example, the Europe is one region. Asia is another region. Africa is another, you can see the continent or whatever is there. It means some group of the states. It is not public international. It is a regional instruments. Regional instruments are relationship of some countries within certain geographical area. In the same way, there is another European Convention for the Protection of Human Rights and Fundamental Freedoms. And it has made in the 1950. And there is one article number 10, in the same way, as it is written under 19 of the UDHR and 19 of the covenant on the international covenant on the civil and political rights. In the same way, there is another legal provision under Article 10 of 1950, which is called the Convention for the Protection of the Human Rights and Fundamental Freedoms. And that is related to the European Convention. And what is the provision under this one? This is equal or similar. Not equal. Equal, it is very difficult to say that this is equal. But the similar, and there are the restriction imposed under this clause 2 also. And these are indication, I have got the indication. Please, it is very difficult for me to complete the one component only. And very quickly, I'm just citing this aspect of this Article 10. And what is it says that there are two clauses. Clause 1 is somehow the similar to the Article 19 of UDHR. Because in UDHR, there is only single provision which comes under Article 19. There is no another clause. But under 19 of covenant, if that will not be completed, I will start it on Monday. Monday, I will take your class at 4. Now, you have seen that 19, there are three clauses. 1 and 2 is a general provision. And 3 says about the restriction. And under the 3, there are two clauses, that is A and B. And A and B, there are the grounds for imposing the restriction. And restriction, you have seen the public or the health and the reputation and the rights not to interfere the rights of another person. And you have also seen the morality, not decency, morality. These are the 4 grounds which may be taken into the account at the time of making the law or framing the law by the state members to impose some restriction on the rights as given under Article 19, Clause 1 and 2. But here in European Convention of this Human Right and Fundamental Freedoms, the Article 10, Clause 1 says that everyone has the right to freedom of expression. And this right shall include the freedom of hold opinion. Same, to hold opinion. It is written under 19 UDHR. It is written under the 19 Covenant of Civil and Political Rights. Hold the opinion and to receive and impart the information. Same is there. And ideas without interference. Without interference, clause 1 of 19 Covenant and the second and third line of the 19 UDHR, that without interference by the public authority. Public authority, as I have said, the public servant, public authority includes all public. Where there is a public relationship, The authority is there, but running by the government directly and indirectly controlled by the government and getting the remuneration or the honorarium or the salary from the public exchequer. That is called the public exchequer. That is the public fund, because the public is paying for that. That's why they are the public servant. They are called the whole department is called the public authority, and basically they have the duty of their work in favor of the public. This is called public, because the public, they are for public. And in democracy, public authority that the authority, and regardless of frontiers, you know, the frontiers mean the borders. There are no borders. Clause 1 says that there is no border. In the same way, the regardless of frontier, you have seen the 19 UDHR, you have seen under this 19.1 covenant, civil and political. In the same way, there is this, the word used the without foreign interference and the without regardless of the frontiers means the border limitation, simai. There is no simai, no limitation of it. And this article shall not prevent states from requiring the licensing of broadcasting television or cinema enterprises. Next lecture will be on the 1952 Act of Cinematography on Monday. There are 17 sections, and 18 is related to the repeal of 1918 laws, that has been repealed. Whenever the new law comes, the another will be repealed, and that we will see later on. Cinematography is our subject matter under the media, and here it says that the state from requiring the licensing shall not be prevented. Licensing, it means general provision is there. As I have said that under the Cinematography 1952, Section 5 says that under which condition the license shall be issued by the board, and constituting the board, that is the provision given under Section 3. We will say later on, but I am just correlating, giving some illustration to understand what is the European Convention on the Human Rights and Fundamental Freedoms of 1950. One of the reason is that the UDHR has framed, as you have seen, the 1948 and adopted by the General Assembly of the United Nations, and the members are open for the to be applied in their domain, in their own country or states. In the international language, the country is called the states. Don't be confused that if once it has been used, the state, it doesn't mean it is a state and a province within that country. No, the international language for the country is the state. And that you have seen, and therefore here the state shall not prevent anyone to issue any kind of the licensing for broadcasting. Media is broadcasting, and television and cinema enterprises, no license shall be prevented or means stopped or not refused. But this is okay. This is the normal provision. This is the provision which is called it is a general provision for all. But clause 2, there are the exception, it can be prevented. But there should be some ground. And these grounds should be made by framing the law. And if he says that the exercise of these freedoms where it has prescribed under clause 1 of Article 10 of 1950, Conventions of Human Rights, and the Fundamental Freedoms, which is called the Rome of 4, means the serial number of 4 on that year 1950. It has been framed by that European system, and that is the exercise of these freedoms, since it carries with its duties of the state, freedoms of the citizen, civil, you have seen, citizens of that country, and responsibility and may be subject to such formula, these sub subject to the sub conditions, and these conditions, conditions, restriction or penalty. If one will not follow, you have seen order of the public and public order. Order public and public order. As it has written under B, under sub clause B of Article 19 clause. Tell me any student can give the reference. The word, two words were there. Public order within bracket, order public. When I have given the example of the 144 of CRPC and 188 of the Indian Penal Code with reference to the Indian system. And just I am quoting the sub clause of B of clause. Yes, please give me answer. You are also studying, I am also studying. Because I am worried that I am teaching to the student, but you are not worried to keep it and to memorize it.
Two.
Not two, three. Under two, there are no sub clauses. International covenant on the civil and political rights, there are three clauses. One is plain, two is plain, three is related to the restriction. And the grounds of the restriction is prescribed under A and B. Whenever you are giving the emphasis and keeping your mind on the particular sub-clauses, it means in future also very easily whenever one will read, there is a system of study that plain, then another explanation, means indirectly it is not explanation, then restriction, general provision for the restriction, and then grounds AB. Writing method in legal system is very essential in the competitive examination. If after these points at the type of writing, at the time of writing, then automatically it means